How to schedule posts on Instagram. Hi guys, welcome to Tejal Talks. Today I'm going to cover, first of all, why should you schedule content on Instagram? Secondly, which tools can you use for doing the same? And thirdly, which is my favorite tool? And then I'm going to give you a small walkthrough of using that tool to schedule content on Instagram and Facebook for free. So are you excited? Come on in. Why do you need to schedule content? The answer is pretty simple. It saves you a ton of time. Yes, I'm right. So let's take two scenarios. One is that you go on the platform each day, post manually while having a look at other things that are going on Instagram, and you know how Instagram can be, seeing those cute baby videos, cute cat videos. We are all sucked into that big hole of being on the platform for too long. Instead, you get to save time there. And then, secondly, sometimes when we are creating content on the fly, that's we've not batch created the content, we might miss out on the content. So the best way is that batch create your content and then schedule it. Have your content for the entire month scheduled so that you don't have to go again and again every day to do the scheduling and posting part of it. You of course can go and engage and use the platform, but you don't have any headaches about scheduling a post. So that is why you need to schedule your posts on Instagram. Secondly, now which are some of the common tools that you can use? Some of them are Buffer, Hootsuite, Planoly, Later, and there are a ton more in the market and present, and they of course give you a lot of insight and data. But there's this tool that I use which gives you data, insights, is free of cost, is Facebook native tool. It's Facebook's Creator Studio, and I swear by it. From the day it has launched, I've never looked back. All my Facebook content, all my Instagram content, all my clients' Facebook and Instagram content goes via it. And the best part about it is that you can schedule IGTVs too. How does it get any better than that? Seriously, because no other platforms give us the convenience of scheduling IGTVs so easily and natively while Facebook Creator Studio does. That's why I'm going to give you a quick walkthrough in a minute as to how to use this tool to schedule your posts. As easy as that. So come on in.
So you can simply go to business.facebook.com/creator studio or just go to Google, search Creator Studio, and automatically it would open. Once it opens, if you're logged out of your Facebook, you can simply sign in using your simple Facebook credentials and you'll be inside. That's it. So I have a lot of Facebook pages and Instagram accounts attached to mine because I handle a lot of accounts using this Creator Studio. So what I'm going to teach you is just how can you check various things and how to schedule content for now. Okay, so if I'm going to Instagram, because the best feature of Facebook's Creator Studio is IGTV scheduling as well, because it's not available anywhere else. So what I would suggest is you can use Facebook's native scheduling tool, which is Facebook Creator Studio, to your maximum benefit, because it's algorithmically suitable. It gives you the edge over others by letting you schedule IGTV videos as well. And of course, it gives you a ton of insights. So what can be better than that? Awesome. So first, let's just start by scheduling an IGTV video. Everything else that you want to schedule would be working in a similar fashion. Okay. So I'll click on the Instagram tab here to go to the Instagram accounts that I have connected with this particular one. And I would simply say create post here, and I would say IGTV. Then I'll select the account that I want to create a post with. You can add multiple accounts. Say you have a business account which is separate from your personal account. You can add multiple accounts in here. And I would select this account and basically upload it. You can also put it from your page content. If your page already has it on Facebook, you can take it from there. But otherwise, simply click on upload. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a video that I wanted to. Okay, I'm just going to show you guys an example of using this one. Okay. And now I'm going to give it a title here. Okay. And an emoji if you like. This is an additional add-on, so you can probably copy and paste your emoticons here. I like using emojis sparingly according to what the content of the video is about. Okay, I'm not going to put it entirely. So here what you can do is, I'm writing ABC, you can write the descriptions as well as the hashtags. I'm just putting one as an example, okay? Now here what you can do is, you can select either of the cover images. So because my video is horizontal, it won't show me a good cover image. So what I can do is, I can upload a custom image. So if I have an image that syncs with the descriptions of what it is, for example, I'm just going to use this as an example. I don't know if it would suit also. Okay, yeah, it would not suit because the dimensions are not correct. So what you can do is basically upload a custom image from here, which is dimensionally correct for what you're wanting to upload. So you can create a graphic specifically as an IGTV cover and then upload that. So I don't think I have a saved one here. Yeah, this would work probably. So these are not related. I'm just showing you as an example. So I can upload this here. If a screenshot of the video that you've uploaded also makes sense, you can use the same as well. So now once I've done this, I want to share the preview to Instagram feed so that I will remain, it will remain selected for me. If I don't want to share it on Instagram feed, I can just uncheck this and make it so that it totally goes to the IGTV and not to Instagram. However, it's a good idea to let it go to your Instagram because the reach would be more and hence the engagement and more people will be able to see it. If you want to share the same video to your Facebook page as well, you can simply click on share to Facebook as well. If you don't want, then you can unselect it. If you are sharing to Facebook, make sure you select a thumbnail for the same as well, for which you can again upload a custom image or you can select any out of here. I prefer doing this, like choosing it from here only, whatever is comfortable to you. Okay, you can simply click on this arrow to see some of the more screenshots available. Okay, similarly for IGTV, but I have uploaded a custom one for IGTV. Now what I can do is, I can just publish. Once this is done uploading, I can just publish it from here or I can schedule it as well. If I want it to go at a particular date or time, the best benefit of Creator Studio is this, that IGTVs can also be scheduled. So say I want to schedule it for next Monday, I can schedule it for this time. And according to my insights, I'll find when people are most active. So say I'm scheduling it for 12:45 p.m. And then I can say schedule. So it would automatically go at that particular time. Once it's uploaded, I can also publish it right now. But for now, I'm not doing it, because I don't want to post this with a wrong image and everything. So I'm not going to do that. This is one part of it. The second part is, I can view all my content here and see the insights related to the same. So this is all content. If I want to go to exclusively video, this would be the option to click. If I want to go to photos, I can select this carousels here. And specifically, I can test my stories as well, which will come here. And then the last one is IGTV, wherein I'll be able to see all the IGTVs of my business, of all the businesses that I've added in here. So this is basically the Instagram zone of Creator Studio. Now, if I want to check insights, I can click on insights. I can explore that. I'll select my own account for insights and I'll see what the activity has been. I can check the insights using the native Instagram app as well as the Creator Studio. So here I'll find the data of what the interaction has been, how many people visited my website, how many profile visits I had in the last 7 days, how many calls, text. I don't put in the number or text number here, so I don't get any of that. I don't have a direction, so I won't get that. But this, all of this is available, so I can measure as to how many has it been from the past 7 days. Has it increased or has it decreased? If it shows a green and upward arrow, it means it has gone up. If it shows a red and downward arrow, it means it's gone down. So that way you can compare it as well. You can see date-wise data as well, how many actions have been taken on your post. It also depends on the content you posted. Say I did not post anything for 2 days, of course the actions would be less. Say I post this today, of course the actions would be more. So according to what you're posting, also you'll get the engagement and interactions here. So be mindful of that. Accordingly, I can also see the discovery. Discovery is the reach of as to how many people am I reaching on a daily basis. So I reached 20,000 people on this day, 25,000 this day. Today I reached 19,000 till now. No, this is not today, this is 13th. So beforehand. Okay, so this is about Instagram. Likewise, you can check the audience as to how the audience is for the same. Here you can see what is the percentage of women and men on your account divided by the age group and when are they most active. So as you'll see for me, it's like more often than not, it's similar for all days every day, but for some people it's very clear as to Monday, Tuesday people are more active, Sunday people are less active, whatever it is, you'll get an insight from here as well as your insights on Instagram. So it gives the same data. You don't need to worry if you're using checking the insights from there, you don't need to do it time and again. But if you want to do everything at one place on the desktop because it's easier, use this. You could also see which countries, which towns and which cities are people coming from. Now, when I go to monetization, I can see if I have any branded content. If I do branded content and share it, I can check it for each account. As I don't, as I won't see anything here. Post monetization, I can go to Instagram accounts and see all of the Instagram accounts that I have added and their followers. I can add an Instagram account from here. As simple as that. If I want to share a post, all I have to do is click on create post and say Instagram feed. If it's anything but an IGTV, and if it's an IGTV like I just showed you, you can schedule an IGTV using Creator Studio easily. The next part would be going to Facebook. Here, similar things would be done. So basically, all the pages are here of which I'm an admin of. If I have to create a post, I can go here. I can create a post, add story, upload video, upload multiple videos, go live, post video across pages. I can do anything from here like that. So whatever you want to do, just go ahead and do that. I'll just give you a quick example of the same. So if I'm clicking on create a post, I can click on this and this toolbox would open up. Now all I have to do here is share, suppose ABC, then I can add a video, share a photo. It's similar to how you create a normal Facebook post. You can create an event, an offer, a job or a live as well. And then when you're done with that, you can click on share now, you can save draft or you can schedule it for later. You can also backdate it. Backdate means even if you are uploading the content now, you can change the date for it to be of an older date. Say you wanted something to be on your profile, but not as a new piece of information, not latest. So you can backdate it. And likewise, when you're done, just click on this button. It's share now because now is selected. It will be schedule if schedule is selected. You can select a date and time here and say schedule. Here you can schedule post. I'm not going to do this because again it would schedule ABC for me, which won't make any sense. So yeah, that is how you do this for Facebook pages. And you can go to your content library and again see every type of data that is available. You can sort information as per pages. So if I want to sort as per my own page, yeah, okay, I'll unselect all first and then I will select this and say view. Now it would give me data of what are the all posts, which ones are published, which ones are scheduled, drafts, expired or expiring. I can see everything here. If only my internet moved a little faster, I would be able to show you some actual data here, but that's how you check it. Yay, thank God it did. So it's not sorting out. I have to sort it out to actually see. It did not take my sorting out action. I'll again say unselect all. Then I'll select my particular page. And then I would hope now it would show me what was my post, what was the distribution. These are the different posts that I've done on Facebook using Instagram. They have been auto posted. This is it. What had a higher reach, what had a lower reach, whose distribution was how. I'll get all the information from here. So whatever I want to see, the insights are here. Videos I can repost are here, playlists are here, series are here, everything is right here. I can also check insights for the same, like we checked for Instagram. It's same, you don't need to worry. How many minutes have been watched till now, what are the top pages, what are the top videos of the pages, every sort of insight is available here. The minutes watched, the 1 minute video views, 4 second video views, engagement, followers, everything. It can show me this data as well. Once you go, then it will show you the data. You can turn it on for it to remind you every single time. But once you've seen it, you can also shut it so that it doesn't show you again every single time. So this is like the recent post data that I had shared. Like this. So I hope you got the idea from here. Then again, you can check for monetization. Inbox would be your messenger. And that's it, guys. That is the best part about Facebook's Creator Studio, that it is native to Facebook and Instagram. It won't hamper your algorithm. Similarly, at the same time, it would help you solve your scheduling problems. So yes, try it out and let me know how it goes for you.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this. If you liked this video, please don't forget to hit the like button and of course the subscribe and the notification button, because that way you are helping me with the YouTube algorithm and the content can reach all those who can benefit from it, even more people. So yes, don't forget, please hit those, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.